Hello, I'm Amy Caples, Assistant Professor of Media Studies and Production at Temple University. Welcome to another installment of the ISMP Video Newsletter in partnership with Temple University's School of Pharmacy. We'll begin this edition with a discussion about the growing complexity surrounding the treatment of one of the most common ailments in the United States, diabetes. According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, 22 million Americans have diabetes. It is the seventh leading cause of death in the United States and kills more Americans each year than AIDS and breast cancer combined. People who have diabetes are at a higher risk of serious health complications, including blindness, kidney failure, heart disease, stroke, and amputations. For years, many insulin-dependent patients have been managed on insulin products with a concentration of 100 units per milliliter, or U100 insulin. But with recent increases in insulin resistance and the obesity epidemic, patients are beginning to require more concentrated forms of insulin, such as U500, to control their symptoms. These changes only add to the complexity of diabetes management and safe insulin administration. Joining me now is Staley Laws, PharmD, and current ISMP Safe Medication Management Fellow. Staley, welcome.
Thank you.
Staley, tell us first of all, what is U500 insulin, and why do patients need to have a concentrated insulin product?
So U500 insulin was developed in the 1950s to address problems with severe insulin resistance due to lipodystrophy, genetic defects with the insulin receptor, or for patients who had insulin receptor antibodies. U500 insulin provides both mealtime and basal coverage and is usually dosed 2 to 3 times per day. Patients who require more than 200 units of insulin per day may need a more concentrated form of insulin because of the amount of volume that can be injected subcutaneously.
So what are the safety concerns with U500 insulin?
So U500 insulin is on the ISMP high alert medication list because any dosing errors could lead to disastrous consequences. And one error report we received, a patient's dose of U500 insulin was communicated as 20 units because the patient had been using a U100 insulin syringe to measure his dose at home. The patient's dose was actually 100 units of insulin. Prior to this year, patients that were taking U500 insulin had to use either a U100 or tuberculin syringe to measure their dose. This was a problem whenever they communicated their dose to healthcare providers because you didn't know whether they were telling you their dose in units of U100, in milliliter, or total number units of insulin. Or with tuberculin syringes, they were often not covered by insurance companies or stocked in the local pharmacies when patients would go home. So a new U500 insulin syringe, which measures from 25 to 250 units of insulin, has been approved by the FDA and is now available. Also, there's a new U500 insulin pin that patients could use, which would also eliminate the potential for measurement miscommunication.
Tell us about some strategies that hospitals can implement to decrease the risk associated with U500 insulin.
In order to prevent drug mix-ups on the patient care units, U500 insulin vials, syringes, and pens should all be stored in the pharmacy. If a hospital uses U500 insulin vials, the pharmacy should draw up the individual patient dose and dispense it for that patient. If a hospital uses insulin pens, care should be taken to ensure that the pen is used for only one patient and never shared or used for another patient, even if the needle's changed.
Anything else healthcare professionals should know about U500 insulin?
U500 insulin is 5 times more concentrated than regular U100 insulin, so it's not interchangeable. Patients should no longer be using U100 or tuberculin syringes to measure their dose of insulin. If a patient gets U500 insulin from vials, they also need to receive a prescription for U500 insulin syringes. Make sure that patients know how to measure their dose using the new U500 insulin syringe and teach them to communicate their dose in units of U500.
All great advice. Staley Laws, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.